What is AMD or age related macular degeneration? What are the reasons why it happens? What kind of a vision loss does it cause? What are the different types of it? And what are the different treatment options available for it? Hi, I'm Dr. Mayank Bansal. I am a board certified vitreo-retinal surgeon, a fellow of the Royal College of Surgeons of the UK, and I'm here going to discuss a few of these aspects which we get asked a lot by most of our patients. So age-related macular degeneration essentially impacts the back part of the eye. So if this is all of the eye and this is the retina, which is the back part of the eye, the centermost part from where we see the most finest things are unfortunately with age start getting degenerated. And essentially it causes a central vision loss or a distortion of vision, but it does not as much impact the side vision of a person's affected body. With age, certain fine deposits first of all start to get accumulated in the retina. These deposits form yellowish dots on the retina and we call them drusens. And over a period of time, these drusens coalesce or come together, and then thereafter the layer of the retina starts to undergo degeneration or thinning. At this stage, essentially, very often we call it a dry AMD, and it causes a distortion of vision or maybe sometimes a black spot. As time goes, most often with the thinning of retina, new vessels start to grow from behind the retina, and they cause what's known as a wet AMD. And this is essentially called wet because new vessels are causing a fluid-like leak into the retina. Now, an important thing to mention here is that it's not necessary that everyone goes from the dry to wet stage. There's a variant called the polypoidal choroidal vasculopathy or PCD, wherein very often we just see the retina to show wet AMD changes right at the beginning, presenting with the person complaining or having distortion of vision. At this point, we often, while examining the patient, ask about certain risk factors why it perhaps occurred. Of most of the risk factors known, smoking is known to be one of the most common risk factors associated with age-related macular degeneration. The other is a genetic predisposition, and this is more so relevant for dry AMD, wherein a mutation of the CFH or complement factor H gene is known to cause a higher chance of causing a macular degeneration. So how do we manage anyone who has a dry or a wet AMD? Well, first of all, after examining the patient, it's best to first take a photograph of the eye, wherein we're able to first document whatever changes there are. The dry AMD generally shows yellowish deposits in the retina, which are called the drusens. Sometimes when it's very thinned out, a significant part of the retina just looks thinned right in the center, which is called a geographic atrophy. Or very often when we do see small leaking blood vessels with a slight elevation of the retina or a little swelling of the retina, that's when we know it's a wet AMD. Sometimes, rarely however, there can be blood which is very obvious in the center part of the retina at the macula. And that is actually a subretinal bleed, which is in a very advanced stage of the wet AMD. So taking a picture of the eye or a fundus photograph is a prudent first step. And along with that, one of the most essential imaging or tests which should be done is something known as an optical coherence tomography or a OCT scan. OCT scan in cases of dry AMD shows us drusens or deposits, which are like elevations on the retina or even very thinning of the retina, like a geographic atrophy. In wet AMD, it shows us level of accumulation of fluid in the retina. And that accumulation helps us determine the further course of treatment. Dry AMD, vitamin supplements in the form of a tablet, essentially called the age-related eye disease study or AIIMS formulation, actually the second, so AIIMS 2, consisting of pigments, macular pigments and antioxidants essentially, helps delay the progression of the changes that are there. A recent, very recent advanced treatment which has just come in is complement factor inhibition via various drugs which are also known to or showing decrease chances of progression of the AMD. Coming to treatment for wet AMD, it essentially involves giving medication inside the eye via a shot. So if we were to give medication as an eye drop, how it stands, it's unable to reach the retina. So therefore, we need to give the medication via a shot inside the eye. And then thereafter, it's able to deliver it very close to the macula. And the swelling that we see in wet AMD because of leaking new blood vessels tends to come down with the medication given IR shot, and then thereafter the vision tends to improve. Most often distortion tends to get lesser. I must add at this point that the chances of vision recovery are very much related to how early on in the condition we're seeing. If the wet AMD is something which has been long standing or has been there for a very long period of time, then giving a medication may not yield as much visual gain. Then there are, in that situation, we're essentially looking at delaying progression, but or maintaining the vision. But in cases of wet AMD, which have been diagnosed early on, giving a medication via shot very much improves the vision. The next most common question that comes is, what is the choice of drug when we're giving the medication via shot? These group of drugs are called anti-VEGFs, anti-vascular endothelial growth factor, and they're essentially helping constrict these blood vessels which are growing, or helping them regress or become smaller. The drugs range from something known as ranibizumab, aflibercept, faricizumab, or brolucizumab, and all of these drugs have various mechanisms of action. Ranibizumab essentially has a life of staying within the eye for 1 month. So it acts for a month's period of time. Eylea or aflibercept, on the other hand, is something which lasts within the eye for 2 months. So what that implies is that we tend to not see the swelling come back in a patient after 2 months of giving a shot. The drug which is by the name of brolucizumab tends to last inside the eye for 3 month period, and a very recent drug by the name of faricizumab lasts actually within the eye for 4 month period. So at this point, I must add that initially, so as to cause a complete regression of these vessels and not having them come back very quickly, most often it's recommended to take shots at an interval of 1 month for all of these above drugs, and which is what is called a loading dose. And once after the loading dose period of the first 3 months is completed, then thereafter, based on how the eye is responding, are the vessels or the swelling tending to come back, there are various treatment protocols that are followed and differ between various practitioners or eye surgeons. Sometimes we follow something known as a PRN regimen, which is pro-retinata, which essentially means that when the swelling comes, we give the shot on the, which is visible on the OCT scan. Sometimes we follow something known as a treat and extend schedule, that you give it for a particular period. Say we're using a aflibercept, so we would give it at 2 month period, then 2.5 month gap, then 3 month gap, irrespective of whether the swelling is coming back or not. And we're essentially extending the gap between two shots. Rarely, however, if it's been a very long standing wet AMD, sometimes the vessels in the retina bleed, and they actually unfortunately cause a sudden loss of vision right in the center. And that's something which is known as a submacular bleed. Treatment of submacular hemorrhage essentially involves first approaching the eye, removing all the gel within the eye, and then via a very fine needle giving the drug under the retina. It's called the TPA, or a tissue plasminogen activator, which lyses or dissolves the clot which of blood which is under the retina. And along with it, very often we also combine it with giving an anti-VEGF drug under the retina. All of this helps lyse the retina bleed, and then thereafter the vision improves over a period of a week, 2 weeks, or a month. That's something that we have a video on already as a surgical video. Please don't forget to check it out. The link is in the description below. So all of this summarizes all the treatment, the diagnosis, the causes of age-related macular degeneration. I'll be curious to hear any questions that you may have and any finer points that you'd like us to discuss. Always happy to share information related to the eye. Stay safe, stay healthy, and wish you all a very, very best of health. Namaste.